So in this video lecture, we will start to look at structured query language, SQL. And this is the language that we're using in order to retrieve data, manipulate data in our database. So it's pronounced as SQL. It was originally developed by IBM as the SQL language in the 1970s, and it's gone through a number of different iterations from SQL 92. SQL 2016 is the current standard that we're using for SQL. So keep in mind that we learned that SQL is not a full-blown programming language, but we consider it to be a data sub-language. It's a fourth generation programming language. And it's comprised of data definition language, which we call as DDL, and then data manipulation language, which is DML. And then we also have SQL persistent stored procedures, transaction control language for TCL, and data control language for DLC. So in this particular course, we are focused on learning about DDL and DML. So DDL, or data definition language, is used to define the database structures. So we use data definition language to create the tables, assign attributes to the table, define primary keys, foreign keys, referential integrity. So pretty much it's used to define the database structure. So once we have defined the structure, we use data manipulation language in order to insert data into the tables, pull out this data, like we ask questions to our database tables, and we can retrieve that data to answer the queries. So DML is also used to combine data from more than one table so that we can look at this data together. So data manipulation language is really used a lot in SQL, because once you have your table defined in place, what's really happening a lot is data manipulation. So we have also stored procedures, which provide us with programming capabilities, transaction behavior, a transaction control language, and also data control language. But in this course, it's an introductory course, so we will not be getting into that. It's a little bit more advanced concepts, but this will give you with an intermediary knowledge of SQL that you can later build upon. So in this course, to learn about SQL, of course, you're going to rely on these video lectures that I'm providing you with. But I also wanted to share a very good resource with you, which we will also be looking at, because it provides you with very good examples to further expand on the SQL statements that we will be writing in this class, which is W3 Schools. And I'm hopeful that many of you are already aware of this resource. So this is the W3 Schools webpage that I've opened here, and this is a great open resource where you can learn about a number of different programming languages and related aspects. We are looking at the SQL part of it, and as you can see, there is SQL tutorials here, exercises that you can work on. When you look here in this navigation pane, you're going to see different topics like the intro. Definitely you want to go over it. It talks about what SQL is, what can SQL do for you. It is a standard, you know, how you can work. So this is some great stuff that you definitely want to be looking at and reading, as well as it walks you through the syntax for SQL and then a number of these different SQL statements. So in this class, as we are going to learn about it, we will be covering almost all of these different SQL statements here, and we will work on some practice examples as well. So again, this is the source for you to go to, because there are some simulations here that you can also work on to further gain some experience. So as you can see here, it walks you through an SQL statement here, and it gives you an opportunity to try it yourself by typing it and running the SQL. So again, a highly recommended resource for us to use as we are learning about these different SQL statements. So again, DDL stands for Data Definition Language, and this is the part of SQL where we create the database schema. So when we were working on creating that bike database schema, we actually ran, like when you created the schema, MySQL workbench shows you the SQL statement which says create schema. That is all part of the DDL, creating the tables, identifying the table fields, using the primary and foreign keys, it all falls under the umbrella of data definition language. And then we have data manipulation language, which we use after the database tables have been created. It's called data modification. You can also say data manipulation, and it's used to query the data in many ways. So DML is what is used a lot in organizations once you have your database up and running. We are pretty much working on writing DML statements to pull this data and look at it in many different ways so that we can give meaning to the data. We can answer business queries. We can provide managers with the reports that they are looking for.